Sleeping Beauty. A long time ago, there were a king and queen who were unhappy because they were childless. But it happened that once when the queen was bathing, a frog crept out of the water onto the land and said to her, "Your wish shall be fulfilled. Before a year has gone by, you shall have a daughter." The frog had said came true, and the queen had a little girl who was pretty. The king could not contain himself for joy and ordered a great feast. He invited not only his kindred friends, acquaintances, but also the wise woman, in order that they may be kind and well disposed towards the child. There were 13 of them in his kingdom, but as he had only 12 golden plates for them to eat out of, one of them had to left at the home. The feast was held by all manner of splendor, and when it came to the end, the wise woman bestowed their magic gift on the baby. One gave richer, another beauty, a thick, a third riches, and so on with everything in the world that one can wish for. The 11 of them had made their promises. Suddenly the 13 came in. She wished to arrange herself for having been invited, and without grading or even looking at anyone, she cried with a loud voice, "The king's daughter shall her 15-year prize herself with a spindle," and fall dead. And without saying a word more, she turned around the room, left the room. They were all shocked, but 12, those good wishes still remained unspoken, came forward, as she could not undo the evil sentence, but only soften it. She said, "It shall not be dead, but a deep sleep of 100 years, into which the princess shall fall." The king, who would fain keep his dear child from the misfortune, gave order that every spindle in the whole kingdom should be burnt. Meanwhile, the gifts of wise woman were plenteous, fulfilled, and the young girl was so beautiful, modest, good-natured, and wise that everyone who saw her was born to love her. It happened that on the very day when she was 15 years old, the king and queen were not at home, and the maiden was left in the palace quite alone. So she went around it into all the sorts of places, looking into rooms and bed chamber just like she liked. At the last came to an old tower. She climbed up the narrow windows, staircase, and reached a little door. A rusty key was the lock, and when she turned it, the door sprang open, and there is a little room sat an old woman with a spindle whistling, singing her flax. "Good day, old mother," said the king's daughter. "What are you doing there?" "I am spinning," said the old woman, and nodded her head. What sort of thing that is that, that rattles around so merrily? Said the girl, and she took the spindle and wanted to spin too. But carelessly she had touched the spindle when the magic decrease was filled and the her fingers with it. And in the very moment when she filled in spin, she fell down upon the bed and started there and lay in a deep sleep. And this sleep extended over the whole palace. The king and queen, who had just come to Rome and entered the great palace, began to go to sleep. The whole of the court of them, the horses too, went to sleep in the stable, the dogs were in the yard, the pigeons upon the roof, and flies in the wall, on the wall. Even the fire that was flaming on the hearth had become quiet and slept. The roast meat left over frizzling, and the cook, who was just going to pull the hair of Sprinkle Boy because he had forgotten something, let him go and went to sleep. And the wind fell and on the trees before the castle, not a leaf moved again, but about the castle there began to grow a hedge of thorns, which every year become higher, and the last spring rose up and the castle over it, so there was nothing of it to be seen, not even the flag upon the roof. But story of beautiful sleeping Vera rose, for so the prince was named, when about the country, so that from time to time things king's sons came tried to get through the thorny hedges into the castle, but they fought it impossible, and the horn held fast together as they had hands, and hurts they catched in them could not get loose again, and deader misleaded. After long year, a king's son came into the country and heard an old man talking about their hedges, and that a castle was stand behind it, which a wonderful beautiful princess named Beria Rose, and been asleep for 100 years, and that the king and queen and the whole court were asleep. Likewise, he had heard too from his grandfather, and many kings, so sons had already come and had tried to get through the hedges. From they had remained sticky fast and had died in pity. Then they said, "I am not afraid. I will go and see beautiful Maria Rose." The good old man made dispute at him as he could. He did not listen to his words. By this time the 100 years had passed. This passed, and the day had come when spring was to awake again. The king's sons came near to the was nothing but large and beautiful flowers, which parted from each other of their own accord and let us pass unheard. Then they closed again behind him a hedge. In the castle yard he saw the horses asleep and spotted horns lying asleep, and the roof sat the pigeons, and with their hedges of wings they slept. And when he entered the house, the flies were asleep upon the wall. The cook in the kitchen was still holding his hands with the boy, and the maid was sitting by the black hen, which was going to cluck. He went on farther, and in the great hall he saw the whole of the court lying asleep, and up by the horn lay the queen and the king and queen. Then all went on still farther, and was also quiet that a breeze could be heard, and at last he came to the tower and opened the door into the little room when Beryl Rose was sleeping. There she lying so beautiful that he could not turn his eyes away, and he stopped down and gave her a hug and just that. Beryl Rose opened his eyes an hour and looked at him quite sweetly. Then they went down together, and the king awake and the queen, the whole court looked at each other in awe, and the horses in the courtyard stood up and stopped themselves. The hounds jumped up, waved their tails, and pigeons upon the roof pulled out his head under their wings. The kitchen creaked and the wall creaked again. The fire in the kitchen burned, and Cricket cooked the meat. John began to again. The cook gave the boy such a box of the ear that the scream and maid finished plucking the hair. And then Mary, the king's son, with Beryl Rose was celebrated with all splendor, and they lived contented to the end of their days. Thank you.